Morning all, hope you're well. Very gloomy, very blustery, slightly end of the world morning this morning. Managed to go on a nice run yesterday, managed to go on another run today, at which point I realised that I've busted my knee from the run before. So I didn't get very far, and then I sort of had to hobble back. Lots of very strange looks from early dog walkers watching a man in full black running gear sort of hobbling like peg leg down the seafront. Anyway, so slightly disastrous start to the day. What have we been up to? Friday we released While My Guitar Gently Weeps onto Spotify, which is very cool. Thank you for the kind words, thank you for the streams and adding to playlists and stuff. It's a slightly strange world and potentially the antithesis of selling handmade CDs to real people, but it does help. So thank you. And there are still people actually discovering those Morning Coffee and Wednesday Whiskey albums. Asking how they can get CDs, and they can't. They're gone. There might be some more in the future, but they won't be handmade or anything. What else has happened? Sarah got my cold, so I'm not very popular at the moment. But she's feeling a bit better today, which is good. Everyone at school has colds. The ones with coughs are sort of being bundled away in bags and bundled into the boots of cars and taken off for a test. And so far, no one at any of the schools that I teach at, no one at any of the schools, even the kids that I don't teach, have tested positive. So, fingers crossed. But it's cold season. So it's going to be exciting when flu season comes along. My current attitude is to stop looking at the graphs, stop looking at the news, just concentrate on what I need to concentrate on, which is basically not the news. Which is what these videos always were for anyway, so this is good. On Wednesday, was it? Managed to fit in a couple of snotty waffles before I went back to school, so we did a bit of Tom Petty on Wednesday. When I say we, I just mean me. I'm just sort of referring to myself in the third person. Well, not even third person. Fourth person. In sort of a Gollum-esque way. but some nice comments. Let's see if I can find them here. I'm still quite snotty, but I'm feeling fine. So please, I do apologise for any sniffles. Tony says, how about some classic Simon and Garfunkel, Homeward Bound maybe? Tony, done them already. Did Homeward Bound solo, I think, and I also did it with Sarah as well. Danielle said, I'd still like to hear Teenage Blood or Little Bit in Me. Danielle noted. Done a couple of songs off Teenage Blood now. Three. David says, thanks for this, Tom. Put a much needed smile on my face. What a great tune. I think I'll go looking for the chords later, as this would be a good shout for my ukulele group if we ever get the chance to be in the same room again. Into the Great Wide Open. Such a great song. Just brilliant. Robert says, hi, Tom. I've been catching up in the last couple of episodes. Great to see you back. Glad you're feeling better. Having been kept away from other people for so long, it seems that we have all lost our resistance to germs. Yeah, probably. This album provided my introduction to Tom Petty in the early 90s, so it evokes a lot of memories. Talking of memories, I enjoyed hearing the Teenage Blood songs from the last couple of episodes. Listened to the whole album again the other day on the back of it. How about something from Too Slow next time? Robert, I've got you. Too Slow out song coming today. Maureen says, even with a cold, you sound good. Get well soon. Thanks, Maureen. Very patient. Julie says, hi Tom, great to hear you're getting your cold under control. Kind of. To save all the effort, you can buy lemon and ginger tea bags. Not a great taste, but you feel they are doing you good. Still on the ginger tea. Not sure if it is doing me any good. But anyway, love the Tom Petty song. I must admit, I don't know any of his songs. Amazing, I know. But certainly worth further investigation. Tom Petty's got a great greatest hits, and he's also got a great two-disc anthology. With about 40 songs on it, which is epic, and that's how I got into Tom Petty. Although, I'm not sure whether artists that you get into via greatest hits, you have active album relationships going forward. Do you? Always struggled a bit with Tom Petty In that, because I love the greatest hits in the anthology, I've never really been able to find albums that I've really delved into. I mean, saying that, I love Torpedoes, I love Wildflowers, I love, what's the one I'm trying to think of? Full Moon Fever. But I become like less tolerant of the bads, of the non-singly songs. But I actually think that non-single songs are actually the best indicator, really, of what the artist's writing is like. You know, kind of in the, almost like the thought processes of, you're only as good as your worst song, if you know what I mean. I'm not sure anyone's ever said that, but in my head there's something to it. Not that it's some kind of Olympian feat either, because I think if you've written one epic song and the rest are rubbish, you're still a great songwriter and that song is there forever. So I don't really know what I'm offering about, to be honest. I've drunk all my coffee already. I can't drink any more coffee. Juicy Ara says, hi Tom, hope you will get well soon. Nice song, it sounds very good as always. I didn't have time to watch the video before, but now it cheered up my night. Thank you very much. Thanks, Juicy Ara. Awesome. What have we got here? Lots of people getting, oh, Maureen got her mug. Everyone being nice about morning coffee. And one mug I told Jenny Weeps. Callum says, love Tom Petty, but never heard this song. Good job, Tom. Susie says, I've got an infected elbow. Want to swap? Susie, how the hell do you get an infected elbow? That sounds hideous. Hope you feel better, super cover, says Susie. Susie, I hope you feel better. That sounds dreadful. Gary says, good effort. I can tell you're not 100%. Wouldn't it be bad if it didn't show through? But it was good to listen regardless. Take care. Thanks, Gary. Leah says, I never thought of that, using your music for brands. I'm in advertising. Leah, how can you be in advertising and have never thought about music for brands? I don't understand. I'm in advertising and sometimes produce videos for non-profits and international brands. Would you be open to licensing your music for the right brand? I can keep you in mind for future projects. Yes, please. By the way, that was a dreamy version of Into the Great Wide Open. I hope you feel better soon. Thanks for a great start to the day. Thank you, Leah. P.S. Would buy a ceramic mug if you are doing more. Are we doing more? Does anyone else want a mug? Leah says, my vote is for Everything Will Change for the oldie pick this weekend. Leah, I've done that one already, I think, although I've played lots of them already, so I could play it again. Neil says, brilliant cover, love that, have a great day. Thanks, guys. Right, I am going to play a super old song. Am I missing any other comments? No, I don't think so. I'm going to play a super old song. This is actually the first ever single that Tom Williams and the Boat released. Officially. So there are three Tom Williams and the Boat albums. 2011, Too Slow. 2012, Teenage Blood. 2014, Easy Fantastic. Before Too Slow came out, the first album, there was an EP called the See My Evil EP, which included five songs recorded in the same session, three of which actually went on the album as well. See My Evil, Get Older, and Strong Wheels. And it also had two other songs called In Love and Kick the Cat, I think. But then before that, I think there was four EPs. There was the Penguin EP. The Penguin EP. Well, actually, there was an EP even before Tom, but it wasn't the same Tom Williams and the Boat, really. Different drummer, different guitar player. Anyway, Penguin EP, the February EP, Got Fuel EP, and Doing My Best EP. Now, the Doing My Best EP was around 2009, I think, which is when we got to play Radio 1's Big Weekend, when it came to Maidstone, and we did a session for Radio 1. When we did our session for Radio 1, so the main song that we took was a song called Doing My Best, which is on this Doing My Best EP. And that's where we met a chap called Simon, who recorded the session in Maida Vale, which is the BBC's amazing studio complex. It's like the BBC's Abbey Road. And Simon ended up recording and producing the first two Boat albums. So yeah. And basically, as far as I can remember, off the album, because we self-released the first album. Concentrate was the first single. Got some spot plays, so like individual plays. 90 Miles an Hour was the second single, which we thought was a pop banger, didn't fly. And then we just put out angry songs that were like live favourites. See My Evil, Get Older. And they ended up getting playlisted. I don't think See My Evil did. Maybe it did. Get Older definitely did. And then Concentrate did when we re-released it after Get Older. Anyway, so this is officially the first single The Boat ever released, called Concentrate. And I'll explain what it's about in a second. I'd love to know what you thought this song was about, by the way. Anyway, it's, this is normally capo 2. So like, there, but I'm going, excuse the croaky voice, it is what it is. 2, 3, 4, out of the rain, bursting through the front door, soaking and bleeding again, I hit the floor spinning, backpack on my back, it's weighing me down, weighing me down, weighing me down. Think it's that I don't know kids and they don't know me, but I know one thing, I'm safer in my room, I've got the internet, I meet friends on MSN, friends is friends, friends is friends, they tell me they'll put stuff in your backpack that'll scare the shit out of kids, they chase you in the street, and that'd help me out, that'd help me out, and that'd help me out, and that'd help me out. But after a while I get tired. They try to get me to study, but I've got things to do, I've got homework too. They don't know my dad, but he's this town through and through. Old school 50 something balding racist, and so his mates are too. For me I'm a modern man. I'm a modern man. I'm a modern man. Oh, oh. I'm a modern man. Oh, oh. I think I'm intelligent. I think I'm open-minded. And I think I've got a worldview. And there are not many people like me around here. I can tell you, I think I'm the future. And I think I'm dead if I lose track, 'cause they don't know my dad, but it's this town through and through. Old school 50-something balding racist, and so his mates are too. Me, I'm a modern man. Me, I'm a modern man. I'm a modern man. Oh, oh. I'm a modern man. With this song, it's a little bit of You Had to Be There. I don't understand this song at all. I'm now wondering whether this song was even on the Do My Best EP. I think it was. How can I Google? Can I Google an EP that nobody heard of? Tom Williams, Doing My Best EP. Let's see if someone's... Oh, here we are. It's on Discogs. What is Discogs? Oh, yeah, there it is. Oh, no, that's the single. Do My Best and Mary. Anyway. This song was like part of this concept EP, this Do My Best EP, which was about sort of humanizing the radicalization of like a young lonely teenager online that was kind of led astray by extremists. Luckily, no one ever asked me what these songs were about because I feel still massively inequipped to talk about them, and I still don't really know why I wrote them, but it was quite interesting. I was just sort of into different things, sort of writing about different things, you know. But there's lots of fun references in there, like MSN and stuff that just doesn't exist anymore. And I remember being at the first UK Arcade Fire show for the suburbs, and they played Modern Man. I was like, what? I've got a song called Modern Man. Maybe they're secret Tom Williams and the Boat fans. They weren't. But it's a really weird song. It's quite rambling, and it doesn't have a structure. And it's sort of, I don't know, what's the structure? It's like, it's got about 7 pre-choruses, and then the chorus is really fast, it's quick, and then it doesn't happen again. So it's just a disaster, really. But I feel like it has a charm to it. I'd be interested to know whether people who kind of came in via Early Morning Rain, the kind of later stuff, gets anything out of this. I have a feeling it's just for the diehards, but I don't understand this song. So, but it was fun. It's always fun to revisit. Songs off this EP that we recorded most of these songs for the album, actually. So 24 was on this EP, but we re-recorded it for the album. Concentrate, track 2, same. I think Mary was track 3 or track 5 on this EP. Track 4 was Doing My Best that we also recorded. I mean, I've got all these songs mixed and recorded that we'd never released for the first album. So next year is 10 years from the first Tom Williams and the Boat album. So hopefully if I release another album next year, that'll be 7 albums in 10 years, which will be pretty good. But maybe if we re-release Too Slow, or, you know, do a repressing of the vinyl, is there any appetite for a repressing of the vinyl? But yeah, there's probably 4 or 5 songs that we recorded for the album that didn't go on, in my opinion, quite rightly. But yeah, I'd love to know what you ever thought this song was about. But yeah, it's about completely fictionalized characters, really. And it's the same characters that are in 24. I think 24 and Concentrate were the only songs that we ended up putting on the album, off that EP. But Doing My Best, we had great hopes for, recorded it for the Maid of Ale session, but it never made the album. Mary, we recorded, and Fee sung on that one. Ant's wife, Fee, who's got an amazing voice, sang on New Guitar, New House, sang on Teenage Blood, sang on Rundown, on What Did You Want to Be as well. Sang on the acoustic versions of those tracks as well. Anyway, have a lovely weekend, everybody. I'd love to know your thoughts on all the things that I asked thoughts for, but I can't remember any of them anymore. I need some convincing decaf, if anyone can recommend any, because I love drinking coffee, and I'm genuinely sad when my coffee drinking window is gone. But have a lovely day. It's a bit of a sofa day today, I think. Yeah, see you soon. Maybe next weekend, unless there's another national lockdown, and then series 2 of Morning Coffee is in full effect. Anyway, have a lovely day, everybody, and see you next week.